Hello, in this video my topic of discussion is understanding the chart for deflection check of RCC elements like beams and slabs given in IS 456-2000 in a real sense. So here I want to discuss about how to understand the chart given for deflection in IS 456-2000 in a practical sense. So let us begin. Now if we see page number 38 of IS 456-2000, then there is figure number 4, that is modification factor for tension reinforcement. So this is the graph. On x-axis it is a percentage tension reinforcement in beam or slab, and on y-axis there is a modification factor, and here it is given for 5 curves, that is for FS 120, FS 145, FS 190, FS 240 and FS 290, where FS is the steel stress of service loads. That means it is the stress in the reinforcement of RCC element at service condition or under the working loads. Now FS is given as 0.58 FY into area of cross section of steel required upon area of cross section of steel provided. That means in the numerator it is the steel required, and in the denominator it is actual steel provided. And we know Fy is the yield strength of steel in Newton per mm square. For example, for mild steel it is 250 Newton per mm square. For Fe415 steel it is 415 Newton per mm square, and 0.58 is because of 0.87 Fy by 1.5, because we know that Fy is multiplied by partial safety factor for material, that is 0.87, and again if you divide it by 1.5 it becomes 0.58 Fy. So Fs is 0.58 Fy, AST required divided by AST provided. So here, depending on the percentage of tension reinforcement and depending on Fs, we get the modification factor for checking the element in deflection. So let us go further. Now what I will do is I will consider a simply supported one way RCC slab whose shorter span is 3 meter. So here L effective is 3 meter. Now here what I will consider is, let its effective depth be 100 mm. That means depth from the top up to the center of the tension reinforcement I will consider it as 100 mm, and therefore effective length by effective depth ratio, that is 3000 mm divided by 100 mm, that is 30. Now if we see clause 23.2.1 of IS 456-2000, the basic value of span to effective depth ratio for simply supported elements for spans up to 10 meter, it is given as 20. That means basic L by D ratio for simply supported beam or simply supported slab, it is given as 20. And L by D allowable, that is the maximum L by D, is given by L by D basic into modification factor, which just we saw in the graph of IS 456. So going further, now what I'll do, that randomly using this graph, I'll assume that I have provided a tension percentage of 0.2, that is 0.2% of tensile steel, and Fs is 240 megapascal. Therefore, when I look into this graph given by IS code, this point is nothing but 0.2% of tension steel. If I take it up, this chart refers to Fs equal to 240 megapascal. Therefore, approximately I can say that for 0.2% of tension steel, the modification factor is 1.6. And therefore, the L by D allowable for a simply supported element is 20, that is L by D basic into modification factor, that is 32. Now, here the actual L effective by D, that is 30, is less than L by D allowable. Therefore, it is safe in deflection. But as a matter of fact, if we look at this graph closely, now let me take one more example here using the same graph and the same slab. Now suppose for this slab, instead of 0.2% steel, if I go on increasing the steel and if I provide 0.4% of tension steel, and then if my Fs is again 240 only, then if I take it up, then my modification factor will be approximately, I can say, 1.3. That means when I multiply 20 into 1.3, then the answer is 26. So here it is not safe in deflection, because actual L by D is 30, and here because modification factor has decreased, therefore it is showing a failure in deflection. Similarly, if you look at the curves corresponding to Fs, Fs is 120 in the top curve, and as we go towards bottom curves, the Fs is increasing. And interestingly, as the Fs increases, that means as the grade of steel increases, then your modification factor goes on decreasing. For example, again if I take 0.4% of steel, then for Fs equal to 290, the modification factor is around, you can say, 1. But as Fs goes on decreasing, that means as we go up, the modification factor, for example, if Fs is 240, the modification factor is between 1.2 and 1.6. If we still go above, the modification factor goes on increasing. That means as the Fs goes on decreasing, that means as the grade of steel goes on decreasing, our modification factor goes on increasing, making the element more safe in deflection. And then we wonder that as we increase the percentage of tension steel, then also the modification factor decreases, making it unsafe in deflection. And as we increase the grade of steel, thereby increasing the Fs, then also modification factor decreases by making it more unsafe in deflection. Now why so? Let us try to understand. Now this is a question, and let us try to find out the answer. Now let me consider one college building. Now what I'll do is, in this college building, I'll consider two rooms. One is library and another is faculty room. Now let me assume that both the rooms, they have one-way simply supported slab, and both they have same shorter span L. That means if the library has shorter span of 4 meter, the faculty room or the staff room is also having a shorter span of 4 meter, and both are one-way simply supported slab. Now if you look at structural analysis theory, we know that the maximum central deflection, or the central deflection which by default is maximum due to the uniformly distributed load W, is 5/384 WL raised to 4 by EI. Now here, since the two slabs have been cast at the same time with the same grade of concrete, so let me assume that Young's modulus is same. Again, we are assuming that both the slabs are of same thickness, so that moment of inertia is same. So here what I am assuming, that the library slab and the slab of the faculty room both have same Young's modulus, and since both are having same thickness, they have same moment of inertia, and they have same shorter span L. But if we look deeply, we will come to know that there will be heavy stacks on library slab, whereas there will be light furniture on faculty room. And therefore, on library slab, the imposed load may be of the order of 8 to 10 kN per meter square. Whereas in the faculty room, due to the light furniture, the imposed load may be in the order of only 2 kN per meter square, or maybe 3 kN per meter square. So there is a difference in W. That means, going further, both the slabs, that is slab of library and slab of faculty room, they have same length, same grade of concrete, so same Young's modulus, same thickness, therefore moment of inertia is same. But the uniformly distributed load W on the library slab is much greater than uniformly distributed load W on the faculty room. And therefore, in that formula, 5 by 384 WL raised to 4 upon EI, though L is same, E is same, and I is same for both the slabs, but there is a difference in W. And therefore, this is a very important point, the bending moment and deflection for library slab is much more as compared to the bending moment created in the faculty room or faculty slab and deflection of the faculty slab. Now, coming to this very important graph. This graph shows effect of tension steel percentage on ultimate moment capacity. Now, what it shows is that on x-axis, there is a tensile steel percentage, and on y-axis, it is Mn by Bd square. That is ultimate moment capacity. Now, here, this graph is approximately linear up to a certain level, but overall, it is a non-linear graph, but then approximately, maybe up to this point, it shows somewhat linearity. And therefore, we can say approximately that as the steel percentage is doubled, then we can say the ultimate moment capacity is also doubled. Approximately, because that is not linear completely, but as an approximation, we can say in general that if the tensile steel percentage is doubled, we can say that the ultimate moment capacity of the element is doubled. And therefore, what happens is, very interestingly, that what people will tend to do, that when there is a heavy load, like just example I have given of library, then there will be more bending moment, and to resist that bending moment, that is to increase the ultimate moment capacity of the slab, they will try to increase the percentage of tensile steel. Here, by increasing the percentage of tensile steel, I am not saying that over reinforced. It is still under reinforced only, but in under reinforced also, they will try to put the steel which is more towards the balance section. That means they will try to resist the applied bending moment due to heavier load by increasing the percentage of steel instead of increasing the thickness. Now, no doubt, increasing the percentage of steel will create more ultimate moment capacity, and therefore it will satisfy the limit state of strength. That means slab will be safe in resisting the applied bending moment. But the increase in percentage of steel will decrease the modification factor as per the figure number 4 of IS 456. And therefore, we come to know that IS code has played a very smart trick in formulating this graph. What they do, that since they know that as the loads become heavier and bending moments tend to be more, the people will try to put more steel instead of increasing the thickness, and the instance they try to put more tensile steel, they decrease the modification factor, thereby making the slab unsafe in deflection. Now, some other people may think that instead of increasing the percentage of steel, let me increase the grade of steel. Again, what IS code has smartly played a trick while formulating this graph, that the instance you try to increase the grade of steel, that means more your FS, your modification factor goes down, and therefore ultimately you end up in the failure in deflection. And therefore, the IS code has made this graph in such a way that we are left with no option than to increase the depth of the slab, because we know that as we go on increasing the depth, our slab will be safe in deflection. So this is the reason why the increase in percentage of tension steel or the increase in FS, it results into the decrease in modification factor. Now, that's why there is a reason why if we see the minimum tensile steel percentage as per IS code in slab, it is only 0.12% of gross cross-sectional area in case of HYHD bars, which is very less, because slabs are grossly under-reinforced. Slabs are very much under reinforced as compared to beam, because we know that slab is plate like structure and therefore its depth is governed by deflection criterion rather than bending moment criterion. And that's why many times when we attempt the design of slab by limit state theory, maybe from bending moment consideration the required depth is only 80 to 90 mm, but still we provide it as 130 mm or 140 mm from deflection criterion, because we know that the depth of slab is governed by deflection criterion. And this is the reason why IS 456 highly discourages the higher percentage of tensile steel in the slab and the higher grade of steel, because they want the designer to resist or to resist the bending moment as well as to resist the excessive deflection by increasing the depth only. They don't want the designer to rely on either the more percentage of steel nor on the higher grade of steel. Now this is what I hope now the point is made clear, because many times the students use this graph blindly, or maybe designers use this graph blindly, but they wonder many times that why the increase in percentage of tensile steel or why the increase in FS reduces the modification factor, thereby making the slab unsafe in deflection. Thank you very much.